On this first lesson, we're going to set up our document to begin working on our map illustration. So the first thing you have to do, of course, is open Adobe Illustrator and create a new document. And if you don't know how to do that, I'm going to teach you very quickly how. So what you have to do is go here on the top panel and click here on File, then New, or press Ctrl N on your keyboard. And once you do that, a window like this is going to appear. And in here, really, what you have to pay attention is to make sure that you pick as a color mode RGB and that you select as your unit's pixels. The rest, the width and the height, we can change it later. If our map illustration needs more room, we can add it or remove it. So you're going to hit Create and you're going to have a window like this. I have already created mine. So here in the Tools panel, if you go here to this tool, the Arbor tool, you can click it or press Shift O. And when you do that, you can move around this to make your artboard bigger or smaller. I'm going to undo that. And you can see here that my artboard is 1280 by 440. And for now, this is fine. So I'm going to leave it as it is. So for this course, I pick New York City as the city that I will be illustrating, but you can feel free to pick whatever city you like, or maybe the city where you live. And really what you have to do is follow along what I do, how I make a really small and simple research, and pick the landmarks that are the most important for my city. So I pick New York City because I think that everyone, even if you haven't been there, you can easily remember the landmarks that are the most important. So for example, if I talk about the Statue of Liberty, you're probably going to have a picture of it in your head. So that's really the main reason why I picked New York City. And I made a very, very simple research. And really the first thing that you have to do when you pick a city is see how your city would look from the air, or in this case, from a satellite. So you can see how I went here on Google Maps, which is a great source, and type in the name of my city, in this case, New York City, and so what is New York City? And it's actually very big because it is all this red area. And really what I want to illustrate is this Manhattan area, because I think this area is the one that all the people knows and thinks as New York City. And also I want to have the Statue of Liberty monument and probably Ellis Island, so I can represent how New York has some other smaller islands. And then I have to think which are the buildings or the landmarks that I want to have on my city illustration. So the two that I think that are the most important, or the ones that represent New York City the best for me, are of course the Statue of Liberty and the Empire State Building, because it's really, really a very unique building and a landmark in New York City. So what I did is you can go here to Free Pick and type Statue of Liberty photo, so you get a lot of references of how the statue actually looks. And then I did the same for the Empire State photo and find some reference of how it looks. And you could do that on Free Pick or in Google. Maybe you find some other photos that you like, and you're only going to be using them for references. So you can find a photo that you think has all the details and save it to your computer. And the reason you want to do that is because we're going to place them on Illustrator, so we can have a reference inside here, the software. So instead of us going back and forth between Google and the software, we're going to have the references here to begin working on our illustrations, or our little illustrations that are going to be on the big map illustration. So what we are going to do is go here to File, Place, or you can press Ctrl Shift P on your keyboard, and then you're going to navigate where all your references are and hit Place. And all you have to do is just click, click, and click. And you can see how some of these are actually big. So I'm going to zoom out. So I'm going to press Ctrl minus to zoom out. And then I'm going to press my spacebar to pan around. And I'm going to actually make this smaller. So while dragging one of the corners, I'm going to press Shift to scale proportionally. and place my images on the right side on my canvas. And you can see how I took a screenshot of Google Maps. And I'm gonna, to zoom in, I'm gonna press Ctrl plus, and then again my spacebar to pan around. I took a screenshot of Google Maps so I can see the shape that Manhattan has, because I want to have it there. And then I'm gonna put the photo of the Statue of Liberty here, and then the other one, let's put it here. Alright, so now that I have my photos there, what I want to do is that I don't want to accidentally select them and probably move them around, so I'm going to lock it, so to do that, you have two options. You could select all your images and then go here to Object, Lock, Selection, or you can press Ctrl 2. And if you do this, now they are locked. And this is probably the easiest way and the fastest for us, because we really only want them locked there, and we don't need to create a new layer because we don't want them to be on the background or something. We only want to see them as a reference, so I think this works well. And if you want to delete them or you want to move them around, you can go here to Object, Unlock All, or press Alt Control 2 on your keyboard. And if you do that, now they are unlocked. Or you could use the other technique, which could mean to have them all on a layer by selecting them and then having it here on the layers. And if you don't see this window for whatever reason, all you have to do is go here to Window, Layers, or press F7 on your keyboard. Once you do that, you can have them all on your keyboard, and then just right here next to this eyeball, you can click here and have a lock in there. And now you are not going to be able to edit your images. But the downside of this is that you will have to create several other layers and just dedicate a single one for this. So that's the reason why I prefer the other method. So I'm going to unlock this one, select them all, and again go to Object, Lock, Selection, or press Ctrl 2 on your keyboard.